We continue our look back on 2016 tonight with one event that had the whole world paying attention. A lot of concerns heading into the Rio for the Summer Olympics, but the actual games themselves turned out to be quite the hit. News specialist Alex Cabrero takes us back.
Free ball coming.
The USA men's volleyball team came back to beat Russia for the bronze medal during the Olympics.
Into the middle!
One of those on the team, former BYU All-American Taylor Sander, who grew up dreaming of competing in the games.
Bronze medal point. Anderson down the line!
I always look at those tallies for how many medals our country has, and I'm so glad that we get to add to those, and it's awesome.
Sander was Utah's only medal during the Olympics. One team expected to medal was the all-Utah men's beach volleyball team of Jake Gibb, who attended the University of Utah, and his teammate Casey Patterson, who went to BYU. However, they didn't make it out of the early matches.
I'm proud of how we fought. That's a great team, and we fought with everything we had.
There they are, on their way.
One athlete who surprised a lot of people, though, was marathoner Jared Ward from Davis in Utah County. He finished in sixth place and thanked all the people who helped him get to Rio.
It takes a little bit more than just doing it for me. You know, it's doing it for so many people that I've sacrificed, from coaches in high school and my siblings and parents and all the way up. I mean, there's just so many people that have invested that it's, you know, I said it at the trials, but it's not my race, you know, it's their race too.
This is the U.S.
Rowing events were postponed a few times because of rain and wind, but Devery Cars of Park City still managed to come in fifth during one of the rowing heats.
I know that it's really awesome that it's the Olympics, but racing is always at the forefront of my mind.
And rugby made its return to the Olympic Games. Team USA even won a match in which Provo's Maka Unufe scored a goal.
Maka Unufe, number 8.
Showing the young team has some exciting players hoping for future success.
That's amazing. I mean, it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and I'm not going to let this go by. We'll take every advantage I have.
He and many of our summer athletes are already looking forward to 2020 in Tokyo. Alex Cabrero, KSL 5 News.